gathered, the Norfolk County District Attorney among them. The pit bull was brutalized. Mary Saladna, live in Quincy, where investigators and ordinary citizens are vowing to stop animal abuse. Mary.
Yeah, Pam, and you know, some of the people that came to the rally and their dogs are lingering at this hour. We have candles lit, left behind. This was really an emotional gathering. Hundreds here vowing to make sure Puppy Doe did not die in vain.
In the arms of the angels.
Hundreds gathered at Pageant Park in Quincy, heartbroken but determined to do something in the aftermath of Puppy Doe. The brutal torture of the young female pit bull found left to die last month in Quincy has struck a deep nerve.
She was a baby and she was beautiful, and no animal should ever have to suffer that kind of abuse.
It's horrific, and what I don't think people understand is the laws that we have on the books aren't effective, and they're not enforced.
Police are still looking for the person who starved, stabbed, burnt, and repeatedly beat Puppy Doe, breaking countless bones. We now know the dog's name was Kaya before her first owner rehomed her on Craigslist. That information has spawned a petition, now 80,000 signatures strong, asking the online service to rethink its policy on animal placement ads.
I would be comfortable if only registered shelters and rescues were allowed to rehome on Craigslist.
Thousands of animal lovers from all over the U.S. have also signed Puppy Doe's online guestbook, many worried there could be future victims.
It is highly unlikely that this level of sadistic cruelty, which I have referred to as torture, could be shown to one living creature and not to others. So this pattern may involve animals or perhaps even vulnerable members of our society, which alarms us all.
And authorities say it's still a very active investigation as to who tortured Puppy Doe. As the DA said tonight to us, we get this. Justice will be served. In Quincy tonight, I'm Mary Saladna, WCVB News Center 5.